What's going on, guys? I'm Jake, the offensive gamer, and this is The Witcher 2 Assassins of Kings Enhanced Edition. Full disclosure, even though it's probably not the best of ideas for me to disclose this, I said disclose twice. I haven't actually played either of the first two Witcher games, and I know you might be wondering to yourself, why would you play the second one before the first? And that answer is actually pretty simple. The third one is coming out in only a little bit over a month from now, and I sure as shit can't play both Witcher games before that amount of time, and I, you know, definitely can't play them both on the channel in that amount of time. So I kind of had to make some compromises. So what I decided to do was study up a little bit on the lore of The Witcher and get a brief synopsis as to what happened in the first game and a little bit of backstory. And if you're interested in doing the same thing and you haven't played either of the first two Witcher games, but you want to be prepared for what happened to the third, look up Shoddycast. That's Shoddycast, I believe. They do a lot of lore videos. They do stuff for Fallout and Elder Scrolls and pretty much anything you can think of that has an immense amount of lore they've probably done videos on. They fucking do a great job. It's a very high production value, a lot of strong editing, and great voice acting. So definitely check them out if you're interested in that whole thing. And I also went around looking for a little bit of, like I said, a synopsis on the first game. And I feel like I have a good basis of knowledge as to what's going on. I actually launched this up before. I did a recording of like 15 minutes, and that was before I did all that research. And I was like, I have no fucking idea what's going on. So I needed to kind of watch a few videos on this whole thing. And I feel like going into it now, I have a much better understanding. And I think that I can be at least a little bit more informed as to how to do certain things. Not to mention, I'm a little bit more brushed up on the combat, so overall, it's just going to be a smaller learning curve going forward. I've done the tutorial like three times now because I'm really bad when it comes to just remembering a whole bunch of things with combat. Like, that's why I'm so bad with games that have a lot of spells and shit like that. It's just like, I can remember them at the moment, but while I'm playing the game or while I'm in combat, my brain just shuts down and it just goes back to, okay, this is hit, this is heavy hit, that's all I know right now. I'm not happy about it, but that's just how things are with me. That's why I suck at fighting games and stuff like that. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoy the series nonetheless. I can't make any promises that it's going to be a full series. I have to be given assurances that you guys are going to continue to watch it. This is going to be a longer series. I'm going to try to post it consistently, but you know, if I notice after like three or four videos that the views are steadily dwindling and likes are dwindling and all of that, I'm going to have to stop the series. And it's not due to I only care about likes and I only care about money or I only care about views. It has to do with the fact that, you know, the time I'm spending on this game is time I'm not spending on something else that a lot more people would be interested in. So you got to take that into consideration. Otherwise, oh, lastly, one more thing. I'm going to have to put at the beginning of this video, like, skip to this point to watch gameplay. But one last thing before I start up, and I'm going to make an announcement video just so everybody understands this completely, not just the people who watch this video, but I'm going to be going on a trip very soon for about 3 or 4 days, and I have videos stockpiled for that time, but that's a big reason why I haven't been posting that much as of late, and I'm sorry for that, that like the past week or so have been very stagnant and very inconsistent. I realize that that's probably not what a lot of you guys are used to. Most of you are used to me posting like 2 videos a day, and I'm sure it's very jarring for me to all of a sudden be posting almost nothing, you know, over this period of time. So I do apologize for that, but there is a reason, and it's going to go back to normal very soon. That's about it. It's been like 5 minutes of me just talking with this, you know, staring into this, main screen. So I'm going to go ahead and start up the game, and yeah, so let's go.
sixes, Daddy needs you. Oh, shit. Ha! 20 orans to Grandad. Looky there, he's awake. You daft! Don't go in there!
Shut it, he's in chains, can't do a thing.
Am I right, Master Geralt?
That wasn't very nice.
Roll again! Why? The dice didn't roll! Calling me a cheat? Take it back.
You guys are idiots.
Look, he's awake again. Monster slayer, my ass. A regular horson. I heard witches all start out as roadside orphans taken in by mages. Mages who experiment on them. Folks say they plow witches come the equinox. That's how they get those spooky eyes.
Enough!
Take him down and put him in the interrogation room.
I thought you died.
I'm not so easy to kill. I don't believe we've been introduced. Vernon Roach.
Fuck you.
Nasty. When after we've been through so much.
Same side of the barricade then, opposite sides of the table now.
You can change that.
You want me to sit on your lap?
Vess! Unshackle him. You will tell me everything you remember. The entire assault. And all that happened in the solar.
And if I refuse?
I shall have to beat you. I've commanded the special forces for a while. Got good at beating others. You're a witcher. You'd endure much.
You better believe it.
Worst case scenario, you'll suffer through it, go back to your cell, and tomorrow, they'll publicly gut you, skin you, and hang you.
Just like that? For nothing?
No. For Temeria.
Downright praiseworthy. Where should I start?
It was a long day. I wish to hear the important bits.
Just so we're clear on this, I was not eager to go into battle. But Foltest is not someone you refuse.
Witcher, are you up?
His Majesty, King of Temeria, Pontar, Mahakam, and Sodden, Senior Protector of Bruges. Summons Master Geralt to appear before him.
Tell him I'll be there shortly.
Sorry to intrude like this, m'lady, but the King...
We heard you.
A pleasant day to you, m'lady. Witcher...
Stupid war. Could have been such a beautiful morning.
A war can never be stupid when waged by your king.
A wise war is a contradiction, Triss.
Then maybe you know just how I should advise our lustful monarch.
Stop falling in love, sire no further bastards, and don't wage stupid wars.
Genius. You know, these bastards could vie for the throne in the future. Then we'd have an even more senseless conflict.
Which doesn't change the fact that...
I know. Foltest and the other northern monarchs are neither the smartest nor the most refined. But they're kings, one of whom we serve.
And I'll see Foltest is summoned, protect him if need be. But once the castle falls, we leave.
Did you dream of the Wild Hunt again?
Mm-hmm. The unlucky assassin? How did the autopsy go?
It was a nightmare. In the months since you killed him, the king's medics poked around in his corpse like a bunch of amateurs. What arrived in that cart? Well, I wouldn't even call it a corpse.
Foltest has some trust issues. Did you learn anything?
His pupil suggested he could probably see in the dark as well as you. I couldn't put an age on him.
The killer snuck past all the guards and nearly killed Foltest and me a month ago. And now you tell me he was a witcher?
Possibly. I'm just saying what the autopsy showed. I haven't told anyone, nor do I plan to. I know what it could do to you if it got out. You might be a savior, a king's witcher now, but masters can be as fickle as the cults they ride.
One of the scouts swears he saw a dragon down by the river, claims he ran into a Scoia'tael unit. That would have been it if the dragon hadn't swooped down. The elves apparently bowed in prayer and he escaped.
A dragon? In the midst of civilization? Please. Besides, does it matter? Witchers don't hunt dragons. Or has something changed?
Nothing's changed. And you're right. It's probably not a dragon. Although it could be a forked tail or a slizzard. Maybe even an overgrown wyvern.
The scout ran into some elves and scurried away. That's how that story begins and ends.
I get the feeling that dream's important. Running frantically through the forest. The Wild Hunt. They're the last things I remember. I wake up and try to relive the dream and the memory, hoping I'll find some guidance. Some clue to grab onto, something that'll help me recover my memory.
Dreams can be very powerful. Some people claim they can even shape reality.
People claim a lot of things. The problem is, it's often nonsense.
We'll know in time. I'm sure of it.
All right. Time to look to the lustful king and his stupid war.
I'll join you later.
Whoa. Frame rates. Okay, we're fine. So, already in that first part, I'm sure if you, you understand that if you haven't played the first game, that might have been a little bit, polarizing to see so much information and so many characters being brought up at such a short period of time. Obviously, it's probably pretty apparent that, Foltest is the current king, of... whatever the fuck the place, I can't even remember what the land is called exactly. But I'm gonna, you know, over time throughout this series, I'm gonna go over stuff that happens or and stuff I have come to understand about, you know, the Witcher series and all that. And if I'm wrong about anything, feel free to correct me and just put in the comments, you know, the reality of it or your understanding of the reality of it even. And, you know, just give me information. I'd love to hear, you know, information about the first game and stuff like that. So, to start off, like, the Witchers, are like this organization of, I believe it's strictly humans, but I could be wrong about that. But this organization of people that are mutated to be able to handle, potions that would normally kill, regular human beings and stuff like that. And, they're specifically trained to fight monsters, like, what was that, like the undead or something like that, and vampires and all these different types of monsters. The funny thing is that they're actually a pretty thankless organization because they're considered obsolete at this point. Why that is the case, I'm not really sure. But it actually all kind of came to a head at one point where at the guild, or what I think is basically the guild of Witchers, which is Kaer Morhen, I think it's pronounced. A bunch of humans, I think bandits even, attacked... Kaer Morhen and killed an abundance of witchers. And my understanding of the first game was basically it's a, not a revenge story per se, but in a way it kind of is, to find out who was behind this and to kill them and, you know, that whole deal. But the second game has a bit of a different story. And another reason why I decided to do the second game was because it's typically higher rated than the first, from what I've noticed a lot of people saying. And also mods, you know? I mean, I added it, already the game is graphically very impressive for a game that was made years ago. But to add mods with it is, you know, it just makes it even prettier. The funny thing is, actually, that I have a pretty good system. I have, like, an i5-4690K and GTX 970. And if I put everything on Ultra and add Uber sampling and all that, even this system can't run this at 60 FPS, which is crazy to me. Anyway, I've been talking a lot about lore and all that, and I'm sure a lot of you just want to get to the game, so we're going to get to it. Can I talk to her? Oh, no, okay.
I'll join you later.
That's all there is to that. So there's a couple things that I can do. Use the medallion to detect nearby threats, monsters, blah, 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 containers.
There's a tribe of wild men who go into battle stark naked. Whereas you love your trousers protecting your jewels. And that magic amulet.
Oh, looky there.
We know each other.
Don't recognize your old mates. We're the Crinfrid Reavers.
I lost my memory.
As did Boholt. After the hunt for the Golden Dragon, he took a spill and hit his head on a rock. He can still be a beast in battle, but besides that, he don't do much save eat and shit. Rarely even lusts after women.
I doubt that's amnesia.
I'm Kennet, and this one here they call Desperate, and this is New Boy. He's apprenticing with us, like. I haven't had much luck with the monsters of late, so we enlisted. Now New Boy's gotten itself into this wager situation. Would you help us for old time's sake? I mean, we all got a little riled. But those are bygones, as I said.
We'd have set you free. The sorcerers, too. Boholt was just fooling about the raping and all.
What rape?
Shut your trap, Desperate. The Witcher don't remember. Waste of words to remind him. We're old mates, that's that.
So you'd have raped this old mate?
Just the sorceress. You were there to kill the dragon, the sorceress too. The peasants wanted at it, everyone did. But there was only one prize, and we argued. There was some commotion, a regular rumble, in fact. We tied you up like hogs, meaning you and the sorceress, and went after the beast. But that dragon crashed us so hard, we spent the next half year licking our wounds. And you done freed yourselves of your bonds.
Who was the sorceress?
Ravenhead she was. Remember her name, Desperate?
Conifer or some such. So, willing to help some old friends, Witcher?
What kind of trouble are you in now?
It's a matter of life, death, and quite a bit of coin, in point of fact. New Boy bet a knight that he'd survive the assault in his shirt and knickers alone. We drunk a bit by then, I admit, but a wager's a wager. Our honor's at stake.
A soldier's honor versus a knight's. I think I get it.
The very core of the matter, Witcher. We're slated to go in the first wave, so the going's liable to be hard. New Boy's brave, but he can't survive by courage alone. In any case, we've come into this bauble that's supposed to protect him, magically-like. You mind casting an expert's glance at it, seeing as sorcery and such is not strange to you?
Let me see this bauble.
Your wolf medallion, I saw it shake.
It reacts to magic.
So it's true, what the priest said. Hear that, New Boy? You'll be safe. We'll fleece that knight, we will.
Where did you get this talisman?
We came by it, let's say. We were on patrol, see, and ran into a couple of novice priestesses praying at this shrine. They were nice, smiling and all.
We don't want to detect them two on patrol. But...
Shut it! Boholt had one of his rare moments of clairvoyance, went rummaging in the shrine and found the amulet.
Who knows what goes on in that head of his, but every now and then he wakes up as good old Boholt.
Aye, he still cuts them down with a single wallop. In any case, we took the amulet and went off to find the rest of the patrol. Oh, the wonders we saw. First, ran into some squirrels, vicious ones. Arrows flying everywhere, but we came through untouched. Barely three of the others still standing when a dragon swooped down, the elves fell to their knees, and we all legged it. The amulet's magic for certain.
Though it failed to protect the shrine from your patrolling.
Aye, true. Well, now we don't know what to think.
There's clearly magic in the trinket, but I doubt it'll deflect swords or arrows.
Shit, I knew it! I told you so, you idiot! Screw honor! Don your metal, new boy! You'll go into battle, confessional and all!
So be it. Though I'd like to have fleeced the noble. Damn shame.
Too true. Overwhelming force, that's what.
Alright. So I did a bunch of things there.
I hate what's in the pot today? Same as you.
Alright, whatever. Okay, so we need to go into journal real quick. So we got a couple of quests here. We're just gonna follow. Wait, hold on a sec. Okay, like I said, I've done 15 minutes of the game, and last time I did this, I really wasn't sure how I could get to these other quests, so I'm a little bit confused by all of that. I don't think I can access a map quite yet. No, wait. Can I? Alright, I can't move it up and down, really. Yeah, no, it's kind of just stuck like this, so... Yeah, I'm not really sure what I can do. So we're just, for the time at least, maybe things will change, but we're going to do the main quest, which is this one. We're going to go around a little bit, looking for different things we can do, because there are a couple things. Wait, what's that? Pick up those herbs.
Laugh all you like. Come the assault, you'll be slipping on that shite.
Alright, so I believe that you're able to do this.
Kick their asses, Geralt!
Care for a shot before you enter the siege tower? Or don't you drink and ride?
I tried this last time, and I'm pretty sure it gave me some experience. Yeah.
Care for a shot before you enter the siege tower, or don't you drink and ride?
Fuck those up. I did it. So I'm pretty sure I got some XP. It's already dead. I took care of all of them.
Kick their asses, Geralt.
A foothold on the wall is all we need.
Alright, so I'm pretty sure I got some experience for that. There's also some over
Greetings.
Here.
Can I interest you in a worthy cause? We could use your support.
What's the cause?
A veterans fund for former fighting men of need.
Uh-huh. Found anyone gullible enough to fall for that?
There's nothing to fall for. It's just some arm wrestling.
Arm wrestling?
Yeah, why? You put down some coin and we wrestle. Win and the pot is yours. Lose and... Well, the coin goes to the fund. Care to test your strength?
Fuck it, why not?
The gods punish those who shed fraternal blood.
Wait. Okay. Okay. Yeah, I got it.
Well, that's some strength you've got in that arm of yours.
That's right.
Maybe you could make a speech.
Is he wearing like a pot on his head or something? That is not a traditional helmet.
Greetings.
Oh wait, don't
play dice poker in a while.
No, we're not doing this one.
It's like walking. You don't forget how to do it unless you're drunk. Roll a few rounds with me.
No, I'm good. I'm not interested in that. Alright, so there's a case over here. So he picked up some leather. So that's a thing.
Ah! Any advice from a veteran?
Nope.
A beautiful day for battle. Fear not, Excellency. We're out of range of their arbalists.
I am no warrior, sir. I must admit, I prefer to joust verbally or with a pen, the emissary of peace that I
Finally. Traitors of the realm boil tar on the walls while you dally with the royal advisor.
How may I assist you, sire?
We mount an assault today, and you'll be at my side. Follow me, gentlemen. Let's not keep the traitors waiting.
Sire, you said we were out of range.
That was a ballista, Excellency. Its arms strengthened with bronze plates and strung with horsehair. It can propel heavy bolts up to a mile away. A deadly and very costly weapon. An experienced crew can cock and release two bolts each minute. Yet it has one flaw.
Your Grace, please take cover.
The recoil of the arms is so strong upon firing that the weapon shifts. It simply cannot hit the same spot twice.
I had no idea Your Grace was a learned military engineer.
I'm not. I gave the Baroness those ballistae 2 years ago for her birthday.
Sire.
What say you, Excellency, of men who live in spite of such wounds?
And what say you, Your Grace, of soldiers who inflict them?
Those who did this live no more.
Master Geralt, I wish to converse with you once the storm of battle has subsided.
Forgive me, Excellency, but I plan to leave the royal court as soon as possible.
Might I know why?
Too often they take me for someone I'm not.
What do they call you, soldier? Wait. You served with me at Brenneran during our foray into the Pontar Valley. Norman Sadel. Still an arbalist?
Yes, sir. Fight has not been kind to me.
Ha! Norman Sador, for your years of faithful service to the Crown, I appoint you Decurion of the Arbalists. Onwards, gentlemen. No reason to dawdle.
All right, so I think it's fairly obvious at this point that the dynamic of this series, if it continues, is going to be like hour-long videos, kind of like what I did with Dragon Age Inquisition, maybe give or take about 15 to 20 minutes. But that's the basic thought process I have. Or am having going into this. It might change, but, you know, 60 plus hour game probably would be a good idea to have longer videos for it. You know, there, it's usually games like this are slower paced. So, yeah. Anyway.
Forgive my candor, Your Majesty, but I must ask, what fate awaits the royal bastards when...
They're my children. If I hear bastard one more time, someone will die. Painfully.
Your Grace, forgive me. But the laws of succession are irrefutably clear.
Piss on the laws. I'll change them if need be. Above all, I'll not allow a band of treacherous barons to use my children as their banner.
Your Majesty is entirely within his rights.
Adder is dead. And I have no other children.
I see.
This conversation is over, Excellency. Please retire to your tent. Black ones in my camp before a battle. What has the world come to? Nothing would make me happier than returning his shriveled head to Emir in a sack. But Triss Merigold insisted I be patient and courteous. Was I?
I couldn't have handled it better myself.
Ha! I always knew you were one of us. And bugger what folks say. They talked about Adder no end. Have you learned anything about the assassin?
Triss did an autopsy. It's possible he was a witcher.
A witcher? What have I ever done to the plowing witchers? Anything more?
He had no medallion, but that doesn't mean anything.
Many in your shoes would have withheld that information. After the battle, Triss will report to me. For now, let us tend to the traitors. Where are you aiming, imbeciles? Soldier! Spyglass! What is going on up there? The gods count at you, Veri! Catch, Witcher. Aim for the rogue with the red plume. Not 6 months ago, he swore eternal friendship to me. Quickly! How much higher?
I fucked this one up last time, so hopefully I can get it right this time around. I think it shoots a little bit higher than intended, so having it, like, right here is probably best.
1.5 degrees.
Why is the king doing that? Yeah, I got him.
Did we hit the bastard?
He's down.
Ha! One less traitor. Time to attack. Follow me, Witcher.
All right, then. So we gotta follow Foltest.
You know, Witcher, I'm prepared to forgive Louisa. All she need do is to kneel before her king.
Very noble of you.
Are you mocking me? Never mind. I'm certain Louisa will realize her mistakes. Besides, children should have a mother.
I'm lost.
It's quite simple. Louisa and I had a bit of a tiff. She made demands I could not fulfill. Understand?
Yep. I think so.
Count Echeverry and others immediately intervened, all noble, all sympathetic. They claimed the evil king would take her children.
Bread and vodka,
they would protect them, even place them on the throne. And the baroness was duped.
Blood and mud,
a motherly love used. In truth, they desire
that's
privileges that would weaken the
life.
Throne.
Take me first.
Your
fuck ball. Yourself, king.
Coin and country there, your wife. And a long road at your toe.
I wonder what happens when the time runs out. Do I die? I'm worried about that. No, I'm fine.
Look alive, man!
I can't kneel. Sorry.
Hail to the king!
Where the hell are we headed?
To battle!
What the fuck do we want?
Victory!
This I like!
Yeah. Do I go over here?
Eyes on the bridge. We're nearly there. Weapons at the ready.
That tower was ridiculous.
It was designed to break the rebels' morale.
A bunch of lords and lordlings took a ride to then pompously stride on top of the walls, while the real army fought and died below them in the shit and piss-filled streets.
If years of service have taught me anything, it's that the Highborn don the best costumes and get the best vantage points, whether at a ball or in battle. But it's not the time for that kind of jousting, Witcher. Continue your story.
Things went relatively smoothly after we came out of that tower. That is, until we ran into Aryan La Valette.
That's interesting, so I can, like, choose how I want to go about this whole story. That's really actually pretty cool. I think I'm going chronologically, but I may be able to go about it differently if I wanted to. Alright, so what I find interesting is I actually have two different swords. I have a steel sword and a silver sword. But during the tutorial, it never really mentioned what the benefits of using one or the other is. Fuck you. And fuck you. And fuck you. And fuck you. Alright, put that away. Put it away. Put it back. There we go.
Lord Sookson, you shall push for the center aisle and bring down that gate.
It's a good day to kill, Your Majesty. Follow me, gentlemen, for Temeria.
Lord Swan, you and your men shall follow me. We must capture or otherwise deal with Aryan La Valette in order to break the defender's morale.
Yes, Your Grace.
Geralt, gentlemen, follow me for the glory. Fall back, goddammit! I forbid you to die like imbeciles. Hear me! They've taken a good position, the bastards. If this persists, they'll pick us off like ducks, and I'm no duck. Any ideas?
That ballista would do the trick.
All right, so got a new objective. Defeat the ballista's defenders and prepare to launch a bolt. So let's go downstairs. I don't think those arrows can actually hit me, so I'm pretty sure I'm fine. All right, so hold on a second. How do I get down? Here we are. Interesting little tidbit of information. Quen is probably going to be my most used spell, and this is basically just to help with health. It can be used preemptively to kind of replenish any damage that I take in battle, but it also could be used to replenish health after the fact, I think. So, launch that shit up.
Stand your ground!
Oh, fuck. I'm in trouble. Die.
Stand your ground!
Oh, I tried to parry that. Oh, God. I'm gonna try to parry.
Kill the Witcher!
Alright, that didn't work. Fuck it. I don't care. Okay, so we also have a couple spells. By the way, I'm sorry. I know I'm going at a very slow pace with this first video, but I just want to give you guys an understanding of what's going on if you haven't played the game, and I want to kind of help myself get a better understanding, so once again, sorry. Different spells. Alright, so we have Ard. I actually had to write this down during the tutorial because I'm so bad at remembering this shit. So Ard is like a stun power. So basically, you stun somebody, and then you capitalize on it. I think it's an insta-kill if you manage to stun them and hit them correctly. I might be wrong about that. Next we have Irden, which is an immobilized trap. So basically, I just put this in the ground, and if an enemy walks into it, they are immobilized. Kind of like stun, but somewhat different. Next, we have Igni, which is, honestly, it's different from a lot. It kind of stands out from the rest of the spells because it's basically just an elemental power. It's like a firebolt, you know, so you just fire, you know, or shoot fire at somebody, and anyway. Next one is Quen. We already went over that. And then the last one is Axie. And Axie is basically controlling the enemy and getting them to fight on your side for a very short period of time. So they all have their own little purpose, and they're all somewhat helpful. And we just picked up some Orins, which I believe is the currency in this game. We're going to kill some more of these fuckers over here, because why not? Hey, what's up? All right, so which one was the... Okay, Igni was fire. All right, wow, that's just pathetic.
Down with tyranny!
Up, bow and arrow.
Stand your ground.
Excuse me. Ow, that guy got me, fucker. Ow, damn it. I got hit again. All right, couldn't get that guy. All right, we're going to go back to Quen so I can replenish that shit soon.
Kill the Witcher!
Got him. Got them all. No, I didn't get them all. Still got that guy. Ow. Fucker. Okay, I actually didn't go upstairs last time, so maybe there's something up here that I can check out. Might be some treasure or something. You never know. Nope, can't open this door. So other than Uber sampling is what it's called. I actually have everything else on Ultra. So, and I'm on it. I'm really impressed with the way this game looks. I believe it was made in 2011. So just putting that into perspective, this game was made in 2011, and it looks like this. And granted, there are some graphics mods on, but, you know, I saw this game without the mods, and it still looked amazing. So, very impressed. Very impressed. And overall, I like the combat. You know, for somebody as simple-minded as I am, it's, you know, it takes a, you know, a little bit of practice to get used to. But most people can pick it up easy and just get started, no problem. All right, so that door's locked. Awesome. Okay, so we got a couple of guys over here. What's up, motherfuckers? All right, so we're going to bring up Igni again. God damn it. Why do you aim for the fucking legs? It doesn't make sense. Ow, come on.
Shit. The lilies!
Okay, come on. Come on, motherfucker. Idiot.
The lilies!
Shit. Okay. Bring up, Quinn. Did they just forget about me or something? Shit. God damn it. That's one thing I'm not too fond of is how, like, slow everything is. Like, if I'm in the middle of attacking, it just kind of forgets that, like, I need to dodge at a certain point. Like, I wish they would kind of just cancel everything that I'm doing at this exact moment and just bypass all that and just go to dodge immediately, because that would make things a lot easier. All right, so maybe Quinn's not doing what I thought it would. Okay. Why? I don't understand that. All right, man. Come on now. Bring him, motherfucker. Damn it. All right, that is one thing. It might have to do with the fact that I'm hitting the shield. I'm not really sure. Like, if I get parried, it might influence all that. All right, I don't know what I'm doing. Bring up Ard. Fucking AIDS. All right, I need to keep in mind the range of this whole deal. Fuck. All right, how do I get this guy to look around for a second? Shit. God damn it, I missed all three times. Alright, there we go. Got him. Alright, I just took the right placement. That's all it was. Once again, keep in mind, there's a little bit of a learning curve for me. There we go. Bring up Igni.
Blow the lilies!
What's up, bitch? Aha! Right over here.
Guess I'll never learn.
Yeah, it's a little Altair nod that they made. Get this little assassin perk. I like to explore in my first little run. I always play the first like 10 or 15 minutes of the game just to make sure it runs well. And I like to explore a lot in that first 15 minutes just because, fuck it, it's not going to be saved, so why not? And speaking of saving, I actually need to do that right now. So that's what I'm doing. All right, let's cock this ballista. Ha, cock. I hear footsteps. All right, so I'm almost at the end of that first little bit of time that I spent playing the game. It was more like first 30 minutes, probably. Okay, all right. Yeah, insta-kill, bitch.
Stand your ground!
The one thing I like is that, you know, it's kind of easy to get overwhelmed by enemies because you're not, like, invincible. So, yeah.
Stand your ground!
Shit. Bad. Die. Fuck. Shit. That sucks. There we go. Oh, that's brutal. All right, then. We got it covered. Wait, can I pick up, is there any stuff? Yeah, there's a couple of pouches. Why not pick that stuff up? Sorry, what's the next thing? Spinning the little wheel here. Go spin, spin, spin. Wait, I thought I noticed something to the side.
Down with tyranny!
There we go. Alright. Watch out. Get Quen. And pick up Ard. Fuck. Ow. Dick. Nope. Hit the shield. I got you on your face, bitch. Is there more? Oh, I think that's it. There we go.
Yay. The cowmen! Storm the tower! The gods are with us!
Are they? You sure about that? So the gods aren't with the other guy? Okay, so do I climb back up? Rejoin? Yeah, rejoin Foltest on the wall. So that's exactly what I'm supposed to do. Probably go up there, I would imagine. I was already up there, and it looked like there was a good little climbing point. Can I sprint? I don't think I can sprint. Yeah, there we go. Come on. But wait, search, search. Short sword. Yeah, cool. Up, king. I'm fucking these guys up. I did it. Wait, there was like a pouch. Yeah, wait, no, there was a thing there. Yeah, pick that up. More stuff, more stuff. God damn it, pick it up. There we go. Hold on, king, I'll save you.
Follow me. Third man to the tower will never want for wine. Hello, knights, they're traitors. Take no prisoners.
Did it.
The door! Smash the door! Axeman, give me splinters!
I feel like there might be stuff up there. Wait, can we hold off? No? Alright, fuck it. Stop attacking me! Stop it! Hey, stop it! Knock it off! Knock it off! Shit. Well, there's two of them. Wow. Why do I get both of the big guys? This is bullshit.
Kill the Witcher.
I think we traded blows right there. Fuck. Fuck. Ow. Kill that bitch. Always go back to Quen. Every time. Bunch of people told me, or not told me, I watched videos on it, but a bunch of people were saying that's what you need to do. So I am doing it.
Father! insist, or be put down like the rabid dogs you are!
Aryan La Valette, this will be no easy task.
Surrender, Aryan! You'll be treated with honor!
Go plow yourself, King!
Bury them in arrows! Come on, men! For Temeria!
They're well shielded.
You got a better idea?
I'll try to get inside. It shouldn't be hard if the archers provide cover.
That's the son of Louisa and the old Baron, heir to these lands. He's hot-tempered but good with a sword. Be careful.
I'll try to reason with him.
Cover the Witcher!
Oh, level up. Go to character in that case. Can I just level up anything, or do I have to do training in particular? Yeah, okay. I can only do training. All right, so what should we go with? Okay, fortitude, dagger throwing. Unlocks the ability to throw daggers, vigor regeneration during combat. Unlocks the ability to redirect arrows. Vitality. Vigor. Either dagger throwing or parrying. One of them. Definitely one of them. Fuck it, I'm gonna... Can I not acquire it? What the hell? Oh, that sucks. Alright, well, if that's the case, then I'm gonna go with dagger throwing. That sucks. I really wish I could parry. Alright, Nah, not daggers yet. I don't think I even have daggers, so... We'll go with vigor regeneration. Alright. So, at the 4, or 4A, whatever, talk to Aryan La Valette, which is up there. That dickhead. Is there anything I can read? There might be able to read some new stuff. Okay. That's a lot of reading. That's a lot. I wasn't asking for that much reading. Come on. Okay, so the check marks are obviously things I've already completed. I rendered this one void, I suppose. Okay, Assassins of Kings. Yeah, alright. Ah, fuck it. Why not read it? Why not? Okay, at the 4A. The siege tower reached the walls and spewed forth its load... Wow, really? I mean, come on. Spewed forth its load of cum, I mean, Temerian soldiers and knights. The battle was joined. Foltest fought in the vanguard. The Witcher fought by his side, protecting the king. Led by these two, the soldiers moved towards the nearest tower, securing the walls one section at a time. The loyalist army pushed the enemy back with Foltest at its head and Geralt but a step behind him. The assault lost its momentum at the foot of a tower held by Aryan La Valette and a troop of skilled archers. Foltest was prepared to take heavy losses, but Geralt could not agree to more bloodshed without good cause. In addition to a strong arm, the Witcher also possesses a lithe tongue, a fact to which many a sorceress can attest. He stealthily made his way up... Made his way to the top of the tower to parley with a proud young baron. Ow, fuck, I didn't realize I could actually get hit. Alright then, shit. Alright, there's a couple guys right there. Let's get the quen going.
Death to the tyrant! Death to Voltes!
I'm already taking some damage. Ow, 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 stop it, stop it. What I do find kind of funny is that, like, against those regular enemies, the second that I start attacking them, they're fucked. Like, they have no capability of, retaliation. Come on. Okay, there we go. I was like, why can't I climb up this? Hey, birds. Fuck you, birds. Wanted to kill at least one of them. Alright, so first boss fight of the game, I'm assuming. Maybe I can convince him. You never know.
The famed Geralt of Rivia. You've fallen low, Witcher. Word has it you're one of the best swordsmen in the North. Time to test that rumor.
Enough slaughter. Surrender and Foltest will treat you and your men with honor.
And what guarantee is there that he'll not cut us down to the last?
None.
Foltest defiled my mother. Now he colludes with Nilfgaard.
The king leads an army. You have but a few brave men and your honor. In a minute you may lose even those. Choose.
Hear that, men! The king sends a witcher and we are to surrender, forgetting the very nature of honor and pride. We must choose. Shame or a witcher's sword? Is that how you would live? Will you bow your heads before Foltest?
Never!
You heard them, Witcher.
This is between us.
So be it. Stand back, men! My nanny told me stories about you when I couldn't sleep. I especially liked the one of Renfrey and her rogues. As I grew, I dreamed of facing you one day.
That dream will not have a happy ending for you.
Stand your ground!
Halt! He's mine!
Uh-huh. I wonder if I could have done that differently. Like, if there was any way I could have... fuck you.
Stand your ground!
Ow. Dick.
Stand your ground!
Alright. Fuck. Damn it! I'm just in the worst place to attack him at certain times. Shit. Can't get him! Motherfucker! Alright, back over here, back over here. Ah, you're fucked. Well then. You're damn right. You learned. You all learned, didn't you? Oh, God!